One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Yes. I don't know where it is.
Welcome, my friends, to Big Brother's Little Brother. I hope very well. It's day 37. The time is now 7:31. Tonight, one of the so-called plastics is going to be leaving the Big Brother house. There's four housemates. Go hood, 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 hood. Yes, in just 3 hours, either Imogen, Lisa, Mikey or Nikki are going to be out, leaving their plastics to be pretty much recycled. Coming up, our friends and family here, everyone. Poor blimey. Best looking friends and family of all time. Discuss in a thesis. And friend of the show, author Marion Keyes is with us. Oh, lovely Marion. Having a look at this summer's blockbusters. I love your hair, Marion. Absolutely beautiful hair. We kick off the show, as we always do. My friends, a little bit of big news. Hi. Breaking news, to start with, just breaking news, yeah. After weeks of speculation, at 12:52 this afternoon, a new arrival entered the Big Brother house. Yes. Now, some of the housemates were less than welcoming. Take a look.
Oh, that's a big spider. Look at this. It's massive. Now, either get it or kill it.
That big spider, innit?
Mate, that's got fair, it's back.
We haven't put that in my head. He's alright, just let him hang about.
Brilliant. Okay, next up, we thought it could never happen. Never happen, yes. But Susley has finally succumbed to the pressures of life in the house. At 1:06 this afternoon, she exploded in an uncontrollable tornado of rage. That's right. And some viewers may find this footage distressing. Distressing. Ooh. Take a look.
Baking potatoes. Oh, for goodness sake.
There's the King Edwards as well.
Okay, can we put down King Edward potatoes, please?
What's the code?
Right, the code is 53. Sorry to be so... I mean, which otherwise one? We're just going to starve.
You will starve. It's 1 o'clock now.
Right.
It's official. She's an ogre. There's no living with her. Now, we've had Tom Jones. Shirley Bassey. Charlotte Church. But none of them can boast the vocal range and a collective back catalogue of our very own Walsh Wonder. Now, at 2:37 this afternoon, Glyn gave us another stellar performance. It was Raining Glyn. Take a look at this.
I wanna love you, but I better not touch. No one says I wanna fold you, but my senses tell me to stop. I wanna kiss you, but I wanna too much. I wanna kiss you, but tell it.
Best yet. Now, my friends, this is what it should sound like. Love one at it again. That, my friends, is Little Brother's big news. If you were locked up in a house for a whole of a week on end up top, having water thrown at you, I mean, and subjected to Glyn's cooking, wouldn't you want to run into the arms of a voluptuous woman? No, I'm not talking about Leah. And again, maybe I am talking about Leah. steady. I'm, of course, talking about the lovely Davina McCall. Thank you very much.
Oh, no, what is it?
It's chalk cheesecake.
No, listen, chalk, I'm quite feeling.
What, you can eat chalk?
I don't know, I just, I don't know.
Can you eat chalk?
Hang on, I'm going to do that for you, dammit.
Was that snot?
Yes, it was.
Thanks.
I'm a mother, but I just had to do that for you.
Thank you very much. I do apologise. It's not on television. But I am on television.
But I just wiped it on my hand.
Do you want to eat this or not?
I love you. I might save the chalk.
For later.
Yeah.
For some drawing.
Thank you. No, for some eating. I'm seriously finding that chalk quite appealing.
Davina, lovely bare feet. Favourite moment of this week?
Pink toenails, do you like?
Yeah, very much.
Favourite moment. Actually, it's not a favourite moment, but it's the one that sticks out the most, is basically Peter's squashing.
Mm-hmm.
And
squashing as in what
he's just getting squashed.
Yes.
But Leah in particular, and it kind of really reminds me of Craig and Anthony.
Really? That bad?
Yes.
I suppose so, because it is the kind of the love that dare not speak its name in many ways, isn't it?
Yes.
She's just going, I don't fancy it. Of course I like that.
And she's so frustrated, obviously. They're all getting to that stage where they're all kind of deeply sexually frustrated. And she's taking it all out on him, I think.
What about this week's punishment? Is Imogen ever, if she survives tonight, ever going to be in a position where she actually gets to nominate?
I don't think she can help herself. I literally don't think she can help herself.
Well, why can't they stop the rule breaking, though, Dee?
Well, I don't think any of them have actually read the nomination rules. I think only one housemate has ever sat down and read them. They're very clear.
That was George on the
way
out.
It's very simple, you know.
It's funny, though, isn't it? Because they seem to be, because it is such a bitchy household in many ways, they seem to be just, they can't control themselves, can they?
Mm. They can't help it.
Now, romance, discuss.
Yes,
firstly,
yes.
Imogen and Mikey.
If I was Grace, I'd be sitting at home throwing food at the television. I'd be so angry.
Chucking water at the
However,
television.
I think...
It explodes.
Allegedly, I've heard Grace has snogged George.
I've heard that as well.
I've heard that. So, you know, Imogen and Mikey, go for it.
Mm.
I think they're kind of quite well suited. But today, I was watching the Cod Split, and Mikey had Imogen in the pool, and she was lying on her back, and he was rubbing her lower abdomen. And when I'm talking lower abdomen, I'm really sorry, this is so unattractive. I'm talking, like, right down there, right near your ninny.
I love that word.
Very near
Lovely.
That area. And I was thinking, that's a very intimate place to
it
rub.
It is, absolutely.
He's holding like that, rubbing.
Finally, what are you going to be wearing tonight?
I don't know if I can speak now.
Well, in that case, you'll have to watch and see. Goodbye, Davina.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye, Davina's unborn child.
Bye,
Davina.
Bye.
Fantastic. Now, Imogen, Lisa, Mikey and Nikki's fates rest in your hands tonight. The remaining members of Team Plastic brace themselves as you decide which one is going to be in meltdown.
Bye.
South Central does it like nobody does. But this is how you do it. Our next guest has sold more than 15 million copies, 14 million to my girlfriend, in 30 different languages, yet she's bound to be penned in for a summer's edition of Big Brother. It's novelist, friend of the show, officially, Marion Keyes.
Hello.
Hello, Marion. Good to see you.
I'm so darling.
Do you like my bag?
Will be sometime.
You're
lovely.
Lovely
to see you, Marion.
You
How
too.
Are you? You got a little friend of the show badge.
Yes,
there.
My husband made it for me. Yes, it's for every time I come on.
We didn't make that for you.
No, it is
oh,
my
lovely.
Own. Yes, I
Thanks
keep it in a special
it.
Box under my bed.
So listen, I always prefer to hear who you don't like rather than who
oh,
you like.
Oh, God,
but
all right then. Okay.
Who do you like to start with?
Well, obviously I love Pete, because how could you not? But I officially want Nikki to win.
Okay.
Yes,
this is interesting.
Yes, and I wanted that for
oh,
2 weeks.
Oh, the Nikki friends and family look.
Yes,
who's going
two
nuts.
Weeks, 2 weeks long before anybody else in the nation wanted her to be the winner, I did.
Okay. What
oh,
is
yes.
it about Nikki you love?
She's just, I mean, I feel for her, you know. She's fine. She finds life so hard. And that malarkey with the mango tart, I really related to that. I mean, I would do that, you know. And the fact that she is really maturing as the show has gone on. And I'd say, like, by the end of the show, she'll be 10 years more mature. So she'll be about 12 and a half, you know, by the time she... You know, our little girl will nearly be a teenager
Absolutely.
By the time she leaves.
But she is just cracking value, isn't she?
And that's she's so everyone... funny. Like, she's so entertaining. I could watch her forever.
Mm, okay. Well, let's go on to the subject then. Who don't you like and why don't you like him?
I'm not keen on Richard,
okay.
Entrenou. Yeah, he's a bit... He's a bit of a know-all, and he's a bit self-righteous. And he keeps kind of saying things like, you know, you're a really vile human being. And I mean that in a loving, caring sort of way. Like, you know, he destroys people, and then he dresses it up as advice, you know. Yeah. And the glove. I can't look at him with the glove.
You don't like the glove?
No, I don't like the glove, and I don't like him in his knickers either. That upsets me. It puts me off my dinner.
The glove is a prerequisite for a sexual terrorist. You do know that, don't
yes,
you?
Yes, yeah.
I don't, you're going to be a sexual terrorist. You've got to have that to do with pearl lace glove.
Oh, please. Oh, no, no, just no, okay. No, no.
Someone else you don't, you're not?
Well, it's not, Leah, it's not that I don't like her, but I am very, very frightened of her.
Okay.
I think, you know, it would be a terrible thing to be an enemy of Leah's. And it would actually be slightly worse to be a friend of Leah's. Because, I mean, God forgive me, but right, she's just super needy. She's just this black hole of need. And I think, like, no matter how much love you give her, it's never enough.
She's a black hole of love, isn't she? Because yes, it just disappears in there.
Yes, and then if you do, Anthony, if you look crooked at her, suddenly she turns on you like a banana. And, like, you're just, you know, you haven't a hope and it's
savage. She turns on you like a banana?
Yes, they're devils for turning on things. You know, that's why bananas are always lying in the street waiting to trip people up, because they hold grudges, you know? And Leah nurses grudges like they were patients in intensive care. You know, she is a woman to be feared.
Okay, let's take a look at Leah. Oh.
I like you.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
I love your laugh, Ash.
You're the most amazing people I've ever met.
Yeah, it's good, isn't it?
Whatever you need, mate, if it's 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning and you can't sleep.
All right.
You're the mummy, and I'm the daddy, and mummies and daddies are supposed to stay strong for their children.
We only want to, like, have a bit of attention.
This thing with you and Aisling's making me paranoid as well.
You seem really distant from me.
I'm not. I mean, I'm not.
All I've ever said about anyone in this house, I've said to the face.
There's no nice about her. You know that she's just acting.
I don't ever make the first nasty comment.
She's really becoming like a... really annoying.
If someone's nasty to me, then they're going to get it back.
Because you're hang out of order, mate. Hang out.
Nail, wait!
No, mate!
Nail, wait!
Take me as I am or not at all.
Now, she's an interesting housemate. I think the house would be a lot poorer without her, wouldn't it?
Yes.
But is she, for your point of view and from your job, is she a good romantic hero to have, heroine to have?
She'd be good in a bodice ripper.
Okay.
No, I think she's slightly too scary for me.
She's a good character to be in a story, though.
She's a good character, but she wouldn't be my main character because I don't know if I could guarantee her a happy ending.
Right.
I'm sorry about that. She'd be better in a kind of a more of a thrillery, kind of a scary bunny boy or kind of a moral fable. Right. Don't get involved with this kind of woman sort of a way if you value your pets.
Now, listen.
You know, I think.
It's eviction night. Are the right people up? Even though you love Nikki, are the right people
Well, I am sorry Nikki is up because, God almighty, I mean, she takes it so much to heart. And I am sorry because the friends and family are here and they are lovely people. But I'm actually pleased to see the Dullards, Mikey and Imogen, up because I'm so disappointed. Oh, I'm sorry. I am sorry because they're such lovely people. But Mikey, I mean, he has not made me laugh once. And I have a notebook. I keep count. Not once. And, I mean, he is a Scouser and traditionally they are a very entertaining race. And he hasn't made me laugh. And what about their love cheats? Him and Imogen? What's... And nobody has remarked on
well,
this.
Well, I would ask Grace about this the other day. She said they're all free agents.
Oh, no. Oh, she's saying that now. She wasn't saying that on Friday night.
Listen, lastly, Marion, where am I sticking this? Who are we supporting?
Oh,
it's
Nikki.
Going to be Pete or Nikki?
It's got to be Nikki.
It's
going to
be
it's
Nikki.
Got
thanks
to be
a lot.
Nikki.
Marion Keyes, everyone!
Wow. Thank you.
So nice to have Marion with us. It really is. That's who she wants to back. It's Nikki, everybody.
Who is she? Who is she? Who is she? Where did you find her?
Brilliant stuff. After the break, going to speak to the F&F friends and family here. Mikey's brother, you just saw that. And like Icarus in search of the sun, I get drawn like a moth to the flames to the baying mob outside. No, I dare not look. See you in 3. All right, God, I haven't got much time, so let's get cracking. Welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. It's day 37. The time is 7:50. That means, what, 10 minutes left? Oh, no. OK, please welcome friends and family, everyone. Beautiful friends and family. First up, Imogen's friends, Jenna and Jenny. Hello, girls, you're right.
Hey,
Now, Jen, Imogen thinks she's going to be evicted tonight because, to quote her, and I'm quoting her here, all right, Jen, she says she's boring and she doesn't do anything. How much do you share these worries? What's going on with her?
I do not concur with that, Damon. No chance. She's not Ellen Bourne. She's a lovely girl. She's outgoing, she's friendly, she's lovely. No chance. She's definitely not going to be evicted tonight.
Well, you better tell her off if she ever
comes
out.
I know, I will. I'd be really cross.
For saying that. Good for you. OK, please welcome Lisa's friends and family, everyone. Nikki and Layla, two friends there. Lisa has been known to have, a fiery temper in the house. How short a fuse does she normally have?
This is Lisa, the real Lisa, to be honest.
Must be terrifying.
What you see is what you get. No, we just tell her to shut up and turn ourselves off.
We have Mikey's friends and family with us, everyone. Brother Martin. We had a cutaway of Martin earlier on. A handsome young man. Mum Jean. Oh, hello, Jean. Give us a smile, Jean. That's more like it. And sister Kate. Jean, if you could speak to Mikey right now, what motherly advice would you give him?
Just to carry on and be himself, which he is doing at the moment.
Wonderful stuff. Great motherly answer as well. We like that as well. And lastly, of course, Nikki's friends and family, a permanent fixture on the show on Friday. Sue and Carly. Hello, Carly. Hello, Natalie.
Hello, Sue.
We've bonded. Sue, you're here again. What the blue blazes is going on? People are going to start to talk. What's going on with Nikki? Is she ever going to be up or not up in a week?
I don't know. I think it's an open book. Each week as it comes, I think she's expecting to be nominated every week now, but she just needs to tough it out.
Okay. Why do you think the viewers are keeping her in?
Because I think she's spirited, because she's funny, and when she's angry or fouls up, she's quick to say, you know I'm like this, but...
And I'll be like it again in 2 minutes'
time.
Okay, brilliant stuff. They're our friends and family, everyone. It's been to chat with them. For now... We are going to give them one last chance to tell the good people of this nation why they shouldn't evict your loved one, OK? Please channel yourself through these plastic representations of the housemates in our plastic booth and in their voices, convince us why they should stay. Imogen, Jenna, step forward, please, you're Imogen's friend. Here we go. There you go, my darling. Kneel down there for us.
Yeah, no problem.
Janet, your 20 seconds as Imogen. Speak through her. Be almost like a shaman of some
sort. Okay, no problem.
20 seconds starts now.
Hello, everybody. Imogen here. I'm a lovely girl. I'm so down to earth. I'm genuine. I'm really caring. I'm friendly with everyone. My mum and dad love me. I'm really nice. I'm really pretty. I'm the Queen of Wales. Please vote me in. I'm not done, and I'm so not boring, so please, everybody, vote me in. I'm enjoying myself so much. Please vote me in.
Yay! Good stuff.
Thank you.
There we go, my dear. Thank you very much. Wonderful. OK, Vicky, you're up next. Here we go. Now then, is the bleep monitor around at all? Because this could be quite dicey. OK, Vixter, your 20 seconds starts... Now.
Hiya, all right, I'm Lisa, yeah. I'm in, I'm buzzing, everything's cool. Keep me in, because there's loads of more mint things to see of me. Bleep, I'm just going for a fag. Bleep, everything's mint, and so am I, so keep me in, please.
Brilliant.
Wonderful stuff.
Thank you very much. Okay, Kate, Mikey's sister, let's go, come on. Here we go. Here he is. 20 seconds. Kit Kat starts now.
Hi, please keep me in. I really don't want to go just yet. I'm having a really good time. And as you can see, I'm being myself. I'm a really genuine guy. Not only that, I think I'm keeping the ladies happy, or most of them anyway. So with your vote and, you know, just keep my spirits up and stuff, please keep me in. I really, really don't want to go.
Brilliant. Well done. Thank you. And lastly, Carly, Nikki's flatmate. Here we go, Carly. All right. This will be fun. 20 seconds starts now.
Hi, everybody. My name's Nikki, and I really don't want to go. Please don't evict me. I know I've complained about the aircon, and I'm really sorry. I've got so much more entertainment to give. Please don't evict me. Please. I really want to stay. I'm really enjoying myself now.
Ladies and gentlemen, friends and family. Well, the friends and family are clearly biased, but are the good people at Bishop Stortford's bowling alleys? Let's take a look.
This week, I just want Nikki to go. She's too damn dobby.
Lisa, you've got to go. You're foul-mouthed and loud.
I want to get rid of Imogen because she's really boring.
Bye-bye, Lisa.
Do I pull it?
I choose Lisa because all the other girls are too fit.
Imogen needs to go because she goes from man to man.
Nikki, you're a sport brat, it's time to go.
Yeah, it's a heavy ball.
I'm here, the Bang Mob are here. Hello, crowd. Who's going? Imogen, you think?
Mikey, because he's so annoying. He's nothing without Grace. He's
you don't
nothing.
Fancy him?
No!
I heard you fancied him.
No!
That's why I was coming to even talk to you.
Not
what about you, sir? Who do you think is going to go tonight?
I think Lisa will probably definitely go.
Okay. Why is Lisa? Okay.
All
right. Don't get on the wrong side of her. Main show starts tonight, 8:30. Switch over to E4 after that to see Russell. We are back at 1:30 with the Evictee on Sunday on Channel 4. Have a great night, as you were.